According to the astrophysicist, surface temperature of the Sun of our solar system is 5778 Kelvin. Not only the Sun, but the temperature of any star present in the space can be known. But how is it possible? Well, till the end of this video, you will be able to do it yourself. In the last video of quantum mechanics, we had known that any object emits radiation due to the increase in its temperature, then this radiation is called blackbody radiation. But at which temperature will a body radiate radiation of which wavelength? It was first explained by William Wiens with the help of classical mechanics. In this video, we will learn about Wien's displacement law as well as understand how this law has failed to explain the blackbody radiation curve. You must have seen an iron rod heating up. When we start heating the rod, first its color is red, then orange, then yellow. On further heating the rod, its color becomes blue and white. From this experiment, it is clear that what color of an object will be visible to us, that is the wavelength of which the object will emit radiation, is depends on the temperature of that object. Let us consider radiation curve of a black body. This is a radiation curve of a black body whose temperature is 4000 Kelvin. This curve is between emittance, that is radiated energy in per unit area per unit time of the black body, and the wavelength. If you look at this curve carefully, it is not homogeneous. At this temperature, the radiation of the longer wavelength is very low. As we come to the shorter wavelength, then there are more radiation radiates of this wavelength. There is a wavelength of which maximum energy radiates. This wavelength denoted with lambda m. This is called the peak wavelength or dominating wavelength. Even though the black body is emitting radiation of all wavelengths, since lambda m is dominating, therefore at this temperature we see the black body corresponding color of lambda m, which is red color. Now if the temperature of black body increases to 5000 Kelvin and draw the radiation curve, then this curve is also similar to the previous curve. The only difference is that on increasing the temperature, the dominating wavelength is displaced toward the left side, that is toward the shorter wavelength. Here the curve has displaced in both horizontal and vertical direction. In this video, we will focus only on horizontal displacement. At this temperature, corresponding color of the dominating wavelength is green. Hence, the black body is seen green in color. Now, if the temperature is increased further at 7000 Kelvin, in radiation curve, the dominating wavelength displaced more toward the shorter wavelength. Due to this, the color of black body changed to blue. William Wien explained this phenomena as an extension of classical mechanics, that as the temperature of black body increases, the dominating wavelength of radiated radiation displaces toward the shorter wavelength. This is called the Wien's displacement law. The dominating wavelength lambda m of radiation radiated from a black body is inversely proportional to the temperature of that black body. When we remove the proportionality constant, then lambda m is equals to b by t, where b is a proportionality constant and also known as Wien's constant. Its numerical value is 2898 into 10 to the power minus 6. Since the unit of wavelength is meter and unit of temperature is Kelvin, therefore unit of Wien constant is meter Kelvin. Since the temperature of the Sun is 5778 Kelvin and it comes in yellow-green portion of the spectrum, the same Orion constellation has two stars. Betelgeuse, which is a red color star, its temperature is 3300 Kelvin, and Rigel is a blue giant star, has a temperature of 12100 Kelvin. Therefore, it can be said that the temperature of the blue star is higher than the red star. Why Wien's displacement law fails to explain black body radiation curve? Actually, Wien's law is very good in explaining at the shorter wavelength of the radiation curve. But at the longer wavelength, this law fails to explain this curve. According to Wien's law, The dominating wavelength lambda maximum is inversely proportional to the temperature of the black body. So, as the temperature decreases, lambda m displaces toward the longer wavelength, and at T equals to 0 Kelvin, lambda m's become infinite. Means, at any temperature, we have a dominating wavelength. While this is not the case in the blackbody radiation curve, at the high temperature, radiation curve follow this rule, but at the low temperature, the behavior of the radiation curve changes, which cannot be explained by this law. With the help of the classical mechanics, Rayleigh and Jeans also tried to explain blackbody radiation curve, but this law also failed. In the next video of quantum mechanics, we will know about Rayleigh-Jeans law and understand why this law can't explain radiation curve.